हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम अंकित एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल। आई एम हियर अगेन विथ यू ऑल विथ माय वीकली प्रेडिक्शंस एंड एनालिसिस फॉर डाउ जोन्स एंड टेक 100। लेट्स सी व्हाट लाइज अहेड फॉर द डे फॉर द वीक। एज यू रिकॉल माय लास्ट वीक्स एनालिसिस एंड व्हाट आई हैव शेयर्ड इन माय वीकली डेली एनालिसिस एज वेल, टेक 100 अपीयर्स टू बी बेरिश, डाउ जोन्स अपीयर टू बी बेरिश। बोथ हैव कम टू द क्रिटिकल रेजिस्टेंस लेवल्स एट 15,300। इफ यू रिकॉल माय लास्ट वीक्स एनालिसिस, यू कैन रिकॉल दैट 15,300 इज व्हाट आई हैड शेयर्ड, दैट इफ इट कंटिन्यूज टू ड्रॉप 15,300 इज समथिंग वी विल अचीव। एंड फॉर डाउ जोन्स 34,500 एंड बिलो 34,500 आई हैड शेयर्ड इट इज गोइंग टू बी वीक, बट इट केम डाउन टूवर्ड्स एंड क्लोज द वीक टूवर्ड्स 34,500 एग्जैक्टली। नाउ व्हाट लाइज अहेड फॉर द वीक, वी हैव टू bear with the analysis. You have to watch the analysis till the end. We will start first with Tech 100 and then following with the Dow Jones. And also those who are new to the channel, let me share, I provide my daily and weekly analysis for major global markets including Dow Jones, Nasdaq, Germany 30, FTSE 100, Nifty Bank, Nifty Gold, Silver and Natural Oil and Crude, Natural Gas and Crude Oil. And this is what the weekly analysis are going to come soon after this video. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe and comment, friends. Those who are regular viewers, please share it across. And those who are new, please don't forget to subscribe the channel. And yes, you can put the notifications on so that you can stay updated with the latest post on markets before market open. You can definitely trade with the levels I provide. So let's start the analysis. Tech 100. Now on the weekly charts, we are going to have a look at the Tech 100. And if you look at the Tech 100, see, one thing is still there is a retracement, there is a drop, but still it is very much in the upward trending channel. So why I am saying so, you have to connect the dots here. Now in fact it come back still toward 15,120 levels, the level at which it consolidated for quite some time. 4 weeks back, almost till five weeks, it consolidated in this level before breaking out, finding a resistance at around 15,700. Now we can again say that there is a support coming into picture at 15,120 levels. If broken, definitely we might see a further drop towards 15,000 levels or so. And why I am saying it's still at an upward trending channel, let's have a look, closer look at the analysis on the weekly charts. Now, can you see the perfect symmetry? Looking at the perfect symmetry, there is still a void which needs to be filled from this candle, and hence lower highs on weekly charts is what we can see here. At the same time, we should not forget, let me take you towards more closer analysis. So looking at the candles here, draw closely. So this is nothing but let me draw more clearly. So this is a channel in which it traded. I was just trying to connect the dots here. Now for the week, we have to also look at the size of the candle. See, the size of the body is bigger, the size of the body is getting smaller, and the tail is wick is getting bigger. However, it is closed at, you know, with the flat bottom, with very small wick, tail, hardly any tail we can observe here. Now this week I will see 15,200 as the first support. Maybe it might try to continue with this drop for first couple of days, and first 3 days maybe it might try to drop and then start to rise again, and the high it could see towards 15,440 levels or so. So this is where the resistance should come into picture, 15,440 levels. But at the same time, beyond these levels, let's say 15,440 to 15,200, below 200, the major support will come into picture at these levels, that is 15,120 levels or so. These are the levels which I am keen to watch out for, and this is going to be a major support level, and this will complete that it is going to enter into a little bearish territory, because see, this is going to fall towards, it is going to retrace further and farther. So that is why I am saying, if 15,200 is taken, next major support will come into picture at 15,120, and if that is taken, definitely that is going to be a bearish indication for coming weeks for Nasdaq 100, which is trading in overbought zone since quite some time. But we cannot say this is just an this is just a retracement. We can still be hopeful that this is just a minor retracement and it is going to rise from here. Also, so if you look at the near term, that is last 4 weeks highs and lows, you can see that 15,200 again 50% of the retracement levels, and 15,100 that is 61.8% of the retracement we can observe till this level. That is why I am saying 15,120 to 15,100 can definitely be achieved if it continues to drop. At the same time, 15,440 450 levels might come into picture and provide a stronger resistance. Again, see, the charts are saying the same. This is the Fibonacci levels. If you see, 15,473 is the 23.6% retracement. 15,328 is the 38.2% retracement. And if you look closely, it has come towards 15,328 and dropped below, slightly close below those levels. So it is again, you know, it will try to head towards 15,200 and 15,100. This is one aspect of looking at the chart. So this is one aspect of looking at the weekly charts. I will give you the levels. Just let me complete the analysis and show you why I am expecting. So also let's have a look. Ignore the last candle. This candle is an error candle here. But if you look at it, see, this is kind of retracement here. And ignore this line. This is a long-term trend line which I have tried to. This is for my personal analysis. Now if you look at this, if it drops, continue. You can clearly see that it might try to come back till here, 14,800 levels, if it continues to drop from below 15,120 levels also. So this level at around 14,800 should come into picture. And maybe next couple of weeks we might see this. But we have to look at the monthly charts, because now half the month is past, and looking at the monthly charts. Now look at the monthly charts. This is the kind of, now it is trying to act bearish, and again on monthly charts the level at 15,100 should be, you know, a stronger support for Tech 100 for any downward move. And if it decides to rise back from here, we might see 15,800 levels in next couple of weeks. So I have to be very cautious. This week I have to be very cautious and be watchful where it takes. Any drop below 15,120 and 15,200 levels, rather between the zone, is fine. 15,200 to 15,100 is still fine, but below 15,100 I'll be entering, I'll be expecting a more bearish Nasdaq for a couple of weeks coming forward. It might hit 14,800 and below levels also, so that will try to put it in the bearish territory. And if it tries to drop, it is going to be a stronger drop. Why I'm saying so? See, the candle here was at 15,000, and if it has to show bearishness in next couple of weeks, it might try to come back towards. Let me try to show you something here. So it might try to come back mostly towards 14,600-700 levels if it continues to drop. Even below that is possible, as it might try to hit 14,500. So yes, below 15,100 you can remain short for the next week also, and we will achieve 14,800 first target and 14,600. But we have to be cautious this week how it goes. If it remains above 15,100 to 200 levels, definitely it might bounce back also, possibly. So now let's have a look at the indicators. Look at the indicators here. This is the 20 DMA, and 20 DMA is giving a stronger resistance for any upside move, which is right now plays at around 15,530 levels. So this zone at 15,530 is definitely giving a stronger resistance for any upside move. At the same time, we should not forget that there is a support coming into picture at around 15,300 levels from the 50 DMA. So this is the support zone as per the indicators. So see, we have seen the charts, we have seen Fibonacci. Now we are looking at the indicators. This is and also see, this is the yellow zone is the Bollinger Bands, and the night now Tech 100 has almost touched the bottom of the Bollinger Bands. We have to be very cautious now. We might see a little rise before the drop, possibly towards 15,400 as well. Now after that, why I said 14,800, even the 100 day moving average coming into picture at 14,800. So this might try to go towards those levels. If it is really bearish, it might try to act towards those levels. Look at the RON, the bearish, the true range, the movements are going above, and see the DPO has entered into a sell zone here, into red zone. So it might try to, if you look at this, see Tech 100 was all the time trading above this greener zone. Despite the drop, it continued in the upward trajectory, and the last time when it entered into this zone was the levels here. If you see here, these were the levels when it traded below in the bearish zone, and we can see that definitely we have seen stronger drops and minor retracement. We can see stronger drop, and this time again the Nasdaq 100 is trading into red. But yes, there could be a bounce back like this possibly, if we have to be hopeful for that, if it bounces back. And stochastic is on the daily chart, comfortable levels. There is a room for upside movement, but it might try to drop before showing any upside move. MACD lines have crossed and are divergent apart. Here you can see that they are divergent apart, and see the curve is, you know, it has to again curve back for any cross, and you can see it is still in sell zone here. The only thing which I am looking forward to, this RSI which is trying to hit the bottom here, and it might try to continue the drop. It might try to enter here till 14,800 and then might try to rise back towards 15,200 and then a drop possibly. So if it may sustain in these levels. See, these are the overbought levels it has tried to sustain, but see these levels where it has hit a bottom and rose back sharply, trying to hit back a bottom and rose back sharply. So I will be watchful how it behaves here. Now considering this, let me give you the levels here. Let me turn off the indicators. So 15,440 levels, it might try to see this high. At the same time, 15,200, 15,120 should provide a stronger support. So I expect Dow Jones Tech 100 might trade between these levels. And in fact, below 15,120, it might try to breach 15,000 levels. If it has to go below 14,800 and 600 towards the close of the month, definitely this week it might try to hit towards 15,000. Remember, 15,120 is the level below which I will be definitely bearish for even coming week for Tech 100. Whatsoever rise it shows, minor retracement it shows on the daily charts, definitely it might try to go back towards 14,800 and 14,600 levels as well. And yes, above 15,440, you can expect 15,480 to provide a resistance. And in fact, if that is taken, I will turn again bullish and I will expect 15,550 and 15,700 levels. So you have to be cautious till 15,480. Above 15,480, you can go long and you can expect 15,550 levels first target and 15,700 next target. But I expect it to drop. I expect it to head towards 15,120 levels, and below that is also possible. So be cautious, friends. Now let's move towards Dow Jones. I hope you have all noted the levels. Let's move towards Dow Jones. Dow Jones closed the week at 34,500. Now you can ignore the lines, these are for my analysis. This is a daily chart. Now let me show you the weekly charts. On the weekly charts, you can see that definitely there is a gravity out there, which is, see, now it has come out of this. This is a breakout, and this was a narrowing triangle. which was clear indication that it is going to drop from here. And I showed it in my previous analysis also that I can sense that there is a narrowing triangle out there. Now it has come out of it and it is trying to drop. And how far it could go, let's have a look here. See, on the weekly charts we can find the it is incomplete, and you can see that there is a support coming into picture at 34,500, which it failed to break. And I had shared in my previous analysis that if it breaks this level at 34,600-500 levels, it is going towards 34,150 levels as well. Now see here, this chart coming into picture and this support coming into picture, after this definitely it is going towards this level. The next support will come into picture at 34,200 to 150 levels closely. But we have to be very cautious here. Why I am saying so? See here, look at the candle size, the body size are big, and here the body size is very small while the wick is big, and hence possibly a flatter opening. And where it goes, see, you have to see this also. So if it tries to go this level at around 34,800 should be the high. If it goes out a little bounce back, any rise above 34,800, I will expect it to hit 35,000 also. So 34,800 is something which I will be watchful of. If it crosses 34,800, you can go long after that. Else what will happen, it might try to open flat here and continue with the drop. Because see, it is close the levels at almost flatter levels, and hence I will expect it to continue with the drop towards 34,200 levels possibly, but with a rise, little rise towards 34,800. So wider range I will try to give, 34,800 to 34,200 levels. But here also this level at around 34,150 should come into picture and provide a support for any downward move. Breaking 34,100, definitely we might enter into a bearish territory, and it might try to continue, or it might try to get this retracement done till towards 33,000 levels. And also having a look here, let me try to give you a closer analysis on Fibonacci. So looking at the Fibonacci, and this is almost covering 3 months, one quarter of candles, more than this weekly candles. And if you look at it, the support levels at 34,330 will come into picture at this is a 50% retracement, and 34,000 levels again coming into picture, stronger support here at these levels is 61.8% retracement. So from 61.8% retracement close to 34,000 levels we might expect, and then it might try to again bounce back a little. But how far this could go? It could go again till towards 34,200, a retracement, if it tries to complete the retracement before starting with the drop towards downside. And if this time it fails to break this level at 34,200, definitely we are going to drop sharply in the coming weeks. And my expectation for market is to shed a little. My expectation, those who know me, those who discuss with me, those who are parts of the premium group, I had shared with them that September 2nd up, we might see a little drop, but the drop has come early. So I have to be very cautious now next week, how it fares. A high at around 34,800 cannot be denied, and 34,200 cannot be denied as well. So now let's have a look at the daily charts. On the daily charts, consistently bearish moves. Ignore the last candle, and if you look at this retracement, and this is not a double top, this is a, you can say, minor retracement, and then it is trying to drop again. How far this could go? This could go till towards 33,800 level, 33,700, and below that also is possible. On the monthly charts, if you look at, see, looking at the monthly charts here. This is the kind of narrowing triangle it was trying to trade. Now this is a breakout which has happened, and possibly after the breakout the next support level will come close to 34,000 levels, and hence we might see that 34,000 on the monthly charts we might expect in the next couple of weeks. Before that it might try to rise and drop a little. Now let's have a look at the indicators. looking at the indicators on the daily charts, the crossover and 150 and 50 and 20 is also happening here. Look at this, the 50 and 20 day moving average have crossed over almost. So hence I will consider this as a bearish indication, and any further drop will see the crossover here is still pending and here it is almost happened. And hence I'll be watchful of this level at 34,500. If it's taken, if it's breached, then yes, we can expect a drop till towards 34,300 and 100 levels, and 34,000 also is possible. So yes, if this crossover happens between 20 and 50, I can see that there is a bearishness in the market, which is already there. Look at the 100 day moving average, which is giving a stronger resistance for any upward move towards 34,700 and 800 levels. And if you look at the Arun bearish, the two range is volatile, indicating more wilder moves. And look at this, this is Dow Jones is trading in a bearish zone here on the daily charts, as I have indicated on my weekly analysis, daily analysis as well. The stochastic is trying to come into comfortable levels. MACD lines are divergent on the daily charts, and the RSI is trying to hit a bottom here. Maybe it might try to go here and then rise back towards. So possibly it might see 34,000 and below levels if it continues to drop. On the monthly charts, 34,200, 300 levels should provide a stronger support. Now let me give you the levels here. As I have shared in my weekly analysis, so see, this is why weekly analysis, watching weekly analysis and daily analysis before market open definitely helps. Weekly analysis gives you a picture how it is going to behave in the week, and the daily analysis before market open, if you turn on your notification, definitely helps you in deciding the direction of the market before the taking a trade. And you can join my premium membership group. You can join the Telegram channel. The links are mentioned in the description. You can join the premium Telegram group and enjoy the trading signals, which are 100% accurate. And I trade only in 100% accurate signals. We trade less, but we trade sure and we profit for sure. And you can also join the mentorship course and become an independent trader, because if you become an independent trader, definitely the insights which I share in my course will help you make better trading decisions. So join the Telegram channel without forgetting. Now let me give you the levels here on the Dow Jones. And if you look at here, 34,500, as I shared in my weekly chart, daily analysis yesterday also, and today I am again saying this is going to be the crucial number I will be watching out for. Below this, I will be directly expecting 34,300. 34,130 and then 34,020. Below that, yes, I am going to be definitely expecting 33,600 levels, and you know, the markets may continue to drop till towards 33,000 this time if it continues, because the outlook which I am expecting that it is going to enter into a bearish territory for near term, that is what is my expectation. But these are markets, because the indicators are almost cooled down to, you know, bottom levels. So we might see a rise post this drop, and then a little retracement on the upside, and then it might follow with the drop. And on the upside, 34,800 should provide a stronger resistance. I don't think that it should cross 34,800, and hence a broader range towards 34,800 to 34,130 is possible this week. It is going to be a volatile week indeed. So trade safely, trade cautiously, take your positions accordingly. But yes, 34,800 should provide a stronger resistance. So above 34,500, you can remain long. We can expect 34, this target at around 34,680 levels should also come into picture before rising towards 34,800. So this level at around 34,680 should provide a resistance for any upward move, and then 34,800 should come into picture. If you see dropping from these levels, definitely you can expect it is going to hit 34,130 also. But yes, it has to break this level at 34,500. So trade accordingly. Do watch my daily videos and analysis. Now I think I have given you enough direction. Please share it across your friends and network friends. I don't have a marketing team. I don't have support it is all you as my family who are supporting this channel, who have supported this channel, and I expect you to continue this support. Please share it across amongst 5 of your friends and your social media platform. It definitely helps me a lot. So thank you very much. Have a great profitable trading week ahead.